Hello and welcome to Your World This Week, your weekly roundup of the biggest news stories of the week. The top news stories this week are:
Prime Minister Narendra Modi is a master of political jugglery, and that was visible in Bharat Ki Baat, a marathon dialogue held by him from the historical Westminster Hall in London that was beamed globally. From sending out a tough message to Pakistan to a strong statement against rape incidents, Modi addressed all major issues. His statement on surgical strike on Pakistan was widely shared. He said, "Ye Modi hai jo samne walon ko usi ki bhasha mein jawab dena janta hai." The stage was set for campaign in Karnataka and larger goal of winning the next Lok Sabha elections, with carefully scripted questions on his big bank development schemes. While Modi was the star performer, the moderator Prasoon Joshi seemed like an unsure bowler. There were some spoilers though, the long act promotions that interrupted the dialogue and a long NRI host who even jumbled up the names. Tripura Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb claimed that internet and satellite are not new but have existed since the Mahabharata era. Speaking at a regional workshop, Deb said that the internet was invented by India centuries ago. Internet and satellite communication had existed in the days of Mahabharata. How could Sanjay give a detailed account and description to the blind king about the Battle of Kurukshetra from Hastinapur? It means internet was there, the satellites and the technology was there in this country at that time, he said. Europe and the US may claim that it is their invention, but it is actually India's technology, he claimed. Three Indians have made it to the Fortune 50 list of thinkers, speakers and doers who are stepping up to meet today's challenges. The magazine said that the Mukesh Ambani's company, Reliance Jio, brought mobile data to the masses and completely upended the country's telecom market in less than 2 years. Human rights lawyer Indira Jaisingh made it to the list for dedicating her life to battling injustice, while architect Balakrishna Doshi earned the laurels for spending the bulk of his 70-year career championing accessible housing, earning the nickname of the architect for the poor joint. The students of Marjory Stoneman Douglas and others ranked schools in the US that suffered from gun violence were collectively ranked at number one, followed by Bill and Melinda Gates and the Me Too movement. Wedding is definitely on the cards for Sonam Kapoor and Anand Ahuja, as revealed by director and choreographer Farah Khan. During a reality show, Farah said that Anil and I are very fond of each other and we call each other Papa G. He's so fond of me that I will be choreographing his daughter Sangeet, she added. According to reports, the wedding will take place on May 6th and 7th in Mumbai itself. The wedding rehearsals are in full swing. Family of the couple have already started gathering in Mumbai to make this occasion special. The bride Sonam Kapoor is a Bollywood actress and a fashionista, while the groom Anand is in the apparel manufacturing business and owns a brand called Bhani. Fans rejoiced when former Indian cricketer Vinod Kambli shared a video of his childhood friend and Indian batting legend Sachin Tendulkar playing gully cricket with kids in Mumbai. Fans have had a meltdown ever since the video of Sachin enjoying gully cricket surfaced on Twitter. Tendulkar and Kambli had a 664 run-run partnership at school level, which was a new world record at that time. Kambli has played his last ODI in 2000 and last Test match in 1995 when he was just 23 years old. Do watch the viral video of the week.
Hall of Famer, but you got your rhythm going now.
Hope you enjoyed this edition of Your World This Week. Have a great weekend and stay tuned to News Mumbai.